Detroit rapper Eminem canceled his sold-out European tour to check himself into rehab after admitting an addiction to sleep medication. We'll have more on this story as it develops.
Shady Records recording artist Obie Trice has apparently survived a gunshot to the head in what appears to be a random drive-by shooting, while Eminem is rumored to be on and off again relationship with
just in, a tour bus involving Eminem's
updating a story we brought you earlier about gunfire at an after-hours club, we've learned that the rapper Proof has been fatally shot.
Shady Aftermath recording artist,
longtime best friend of Eminem and a member of the rap group D12.
Well, back in the news again today.
Is it a sabbatical or the end? The rumors and speculation continue to swirl around Eminem. He insists he's just taking a break, but doubters believe he's retiring. Leaving us all to ask, will the real Slim Shady please stand up?
So this is it. This is what I wish for. This isn't how I envisioned it. Fame to the point of imprisonment. I just thought the shit would be different, but something changed the minute that I got a whiff of it. I started to inhale it, smell it, started sniffing it, and it became my cocaine. I just couldn't quit, I just wanted a little bit. Then it turned me to a monster. I became a hypocrite, concert after concert. I was raking in the dough, rolling in green. Had the game hemmed up like a sewing machine, but I was losing my freedom. There was nowhere for me to not go and be seen, and just go and be me, and there was no in between. You either loved it or hated. Every CD critics gave it a 3, then 3 years later they go back and re-rate it and call the Slim Shady LP the greatest. The Marshall Mathers was a classic, the Eminem show was fantastic, but Encore just didn't have the caliber to match it. I guess enough time just ain't passed yet. A couple more years, that shit'll be illmatic, and 8 years later I'm still at it. Divorced, remarried, a felon, a father, sleeping pill addict. And this is real talk, I feel like the Incredible Hulk. My back has been broke and I can still walk.
So be careful what you wish for, cause you just might get it. And if you get it, then you just might not know what to do with it, cause it might just come back on you tenfold.
Eating already, are we?
Who the fuck, sir?
Whether you want to believe it or not, I'm you.
Didn't we, like, just meet? This is becoming really insignificant. I'm seeing you quite often.
It appears we do, don't we?
Like, no offense or anything. I think you're cool, but, like, the idea of meeting myself should be a once-in-a-lifetime thing. It's almost like there's been a movie about it before, and maybe even an episode about it already, so don't we meet each other too often? What do you want this time?
Well, this time, what I want to talk about is this idea for a face tattoo I have. I don't know if I should get it.
Why wouldn't you get a face tattoo? That's the coolest thing in the world. I've always wanted one. If the roles were reversed, I would hope that you would tell me to get one.
Well, because this tattoo might be racist.
Okay, so tell me the idea.
It's a tattoo that is going to be right here, and it's like a line. So like, when I turn my face like this, or when you're looking at me from an angle like over here, like it looks like my nose is bigger, you know? And I don't know. Is that racist? That's racist. Asking if that's racist is that's what makes that racist. You're just assuming that people of color have bigger noses. Have you not seen a white man with a big nose? What? Why do you care anyway so much about the tattoo and whether or not it's racist? If you don't know how to define whether or not that's racist, don't get the tattoo for sure, because Then when people are gonna ask you what it means, you're gonna do what you're doing to me right now, and you're gonna overthink it, and you're gonna come off as racist. So for sure, don't get a face tattoo then. In this one particular case, and only this one particular case, I'm glad that you asked me and you didn't just go ahead and get the face tattoo. And why would you even want to get just a line on your face? Like, isn't a teardrop cooler? Or the Harry Potter scar? That would be a cool face tattoo. But that's so standard, man. What the hell? And I'm asking because I've been thinking about it a lot. And like, all this shit, man, this shit, you know what I mean? Of like, being an artist and like, putting your shit out there, you know? Like, we got a legacy, man, you know what I mean? And like Michael Jackson, you know? Or O.J. Simpson. O.J. was an athlete. An athletic artist. They both are remembered for the things that they did wrong rather than the things that they did right. I am worried, and I don't want to end up like that. You know? Aside from all the hippie man shit, you make a scary good point. But, I mean, if we worry too hard about the future, then we let the past slip away. Then it becomes not fun anymore. We don't want that. We don't want this to become not fun anymore, do we? Because then, what's the point of doing it? It's just like, you know, if Abraham Lincoln used Twitter, if he was alive to use Twitter, and he did use Twitter, I'm sure we wouldn't look at him the same. Because you use that internet shit to express your thoughts. So we're really just trapped in it, you know? No matter how hard we try, we're never gonna have the untangible, perfect legacy that we want. And the sooner we get a grip on that, the sooner that we come to terms with that, that's when this doesn't seem so much like a job. That's when this becomes fun. So really what you're asking me is, if I'm having fun doing my dream, or if I'm viewing it as a job doing my dream. I know I'm dreaming. And I know that this is something that I need to bring into the real world with me, but I don't know if I can. I don't know if I can because of the fact that this is a thought I can't come face to face with in the real world. Because what if I don't like the answer? Fuck. I do view it as a job. Because I think of all the twines of all the projects. And I think of all the ones that I haven't touched yet. And you're right. You're gonna have to come back to me at a later date. Because I'm not quite ready yet.
CDs ain't selling no more anyways, man. Look at SoundScan. I really don't think it matters if
everything I do is number one. That makes you two, and that spells trouble for me and you. Cause that's how beef starts between grooves, and I don't mind.